Fees, fees, fees. This video is all about private mortgage lender fees, how they're determined, what you can expect if you're applying, and how to keep those costs low. Join me as I cover all these details. Let's go. Private or home equity mortgages carry high interest costs. It's inevitable, and it's the return that investors demand for taking the risk on your mortgage application. But in addition to the higher interest rates, you also have to consider fees. And it's very common for the actual lender, the administrator of the money, to charge what are known as lender fees. So why is it that a lender will charge a fee on top of the interest? Well, generally, the way that private mortgage lenders are structured is that they have investors or groups of investors, and to get the capital, to get that money, they have to pay an interest rate to them. And that's what your interest does. It's paying the investors in those funds. But those funds are quite expensive. There's a lot of administration, there's a lot of staff, and so the private lender fees are used to cover the administrative costs of running those private lenders. So what can you expect as a private mortgage lender fee? Well, there is no steadfast rule. The market currently is charging about 2% in lender fees. So that means that if you're borrowing $100,000 as a private mortgage, the 2% lender fee is $2,000. But depending on the degree of difficulty, the level of risk, lenders may take advantage and charge a higher fee. And also, if your risk is lower, you may find lenders that will charge a 1% fee or less. To find lenders that charge no fee, that's hard to find. In general, what they'll do is they'll say, okay, no lender fee, but we're gonna just put it into the mortgage interest rate that we charge you. So one way or another, you always end up paying for lender fees, whether you like it or not. In addition to lender fees, there are a few other costs that you have to consider when applying for a private mortgage. And they include the broker fee if you're using a broker, your legal fees to set up that mortgage, and in almost all cases, there's going to be an appraisal required from an independent third-party appraiser. Broker fees are generally about 1% of the mortgage amount. So if you add a 2% lender fee plus 1% broker fee, you're looking at about 3% in fees. Legal fees, when we're dealing with private mortgages, there is a requirement that two lawyers are involved. One to provide independent legal representation to you as a borrower, and another lawyer to represent the lender and the requirements of the lender. So that's two legal fees that need to be paid. And appraisals, well, they can vary widely from $300 all the way to $1,000, depending on the complexity of the report. If it's rural, if it's condo, all these things determine the pricing of appraisal fees. So now the question is, how do you keep these costs low? And the answer is that it may seem like an obvious one, that is to shop it around. How do you shop it around? Call, talk to brokers like myself. We have access to various lenders, and our job is to make sure that we are connecting you with the most efficient and best suited mortgage. You'd be surprised how much variation there can be between lenders. And it's all in the presentation of your application to that lender. And that is where a broker is worth their weight in gold to ensure that you are getting the best deal possible from your private mortgage lender. My name is Chris Mulder. I am a Toronto-based mortgage broker who specializes in private mortgage financing and second mortgages. If you have any questions or concerns, or you are considering applying for a private mortgage, feel free to reach out with confidence. My contact information will follow. Bye for now.